This is the very first game I've ever made. I was something like 8, 9, 10 years old when I started making these.
There are no precise numbers because it was too long ago.
But I do remember making this for a primary school teacher as a parting gift.
This is a game I made as a birthday present for a friend. Even when I play it today, it's still brutally hard.
This is a game I made for my sister, featuring her favorite plushies.
Walk through a dangerous forest, sneak into the magician's castle, escape from a burning house, and save the community!
I really liked gifting these games to friends and family. That's what kept me going in the beginning.
I have about 20 years worth of video games that I made, and you can really see my development in them. You can see what I was thinking about, you can see what interested me. To me, it kind of feels like a very weird kind of historical record of pretty much my entire life.
For example, this is Age of Pinkies, and I made this game when I started getting interested in strategy games.
And if I say interested, I mean, dude, I made a lot of them.
And they were hard.
Hard! I still can't beat this!
I loved drawing labyrinths when I was younger, so obviously there had to be a game about that as well. Space travel and aliens was something I was very interested in, so I made a strategy game about that.
Hast du schon mal über einen Strategiewechsel nachgedacht?
The enemy AI is even bantering with you a bit. Speaking of AI, the time I got interested in strategy games was also the time I got interested in AI. Slowly but surely making more and more complex ones, like this 4-in-a-row AI that just completely destroyed me when I recorded this. I think I didn't really know how bullet hell games work back then, because how the hell are you supposed to dodge that? Well, at least I already had some creative ideas for levels, I guess. This must be a game I made when our parents read us a certain book, turned it into a strategy game, of course, because of course I did. I was a big fan of fireworks, so I made a fireworks game every year. When I got into filmmaking, I also tried to make a full film in my game engine.
Natürlich, da liegt doch Obi Schlan.
This is a troll game where you have to press the OK button 150 times before the timer runs out. It's not possible. Like, I really tried to test my boundaries. This is a personality test, for example. I tried out weird color effects. I dipped my toes into 3D. That allowed me to make this extremely creepy horror game, specifically designed to jump scare you. You can also see which games I or my friends played back then. This must have been around the time GTA was popular. What gave it away? The tanks, maybe? I don't know. This was definitely around the time N++ was popular in my school. This was definitely around the time Worms was cool in my school. I made this super grindy, plushie-inspired role-playing game when MMORPGs were cool in my school. This was when learning how to type on a keyboard was cool in school. Okay, maybe that wasn't that cool because we had to do it, but this is a pretty cool diving game where the deeper you go, the more alien everything gets. And somewhere around that time, I think you can see my game dev skills picking up quite a bit. I started making more complex stuff like this, where you can pick the formation of your own units. I started finding a lot of fun in balancing numbers for upgrades and abilities. That's why I never struggled with math at school. You just gotta be interested. This was when I started playing puzzle games and therefore also started making them. The levels are unbelievably hard. I can't beat them anymore. I forgot the solution. No chance. Making a tower defense game was an obvious thing to do with the interests I had at the time.
I started hanging out on the internet, so this happened. Maybe you remember Nyan Cat?
This is a fan game I made for a German YouTuber called Fresh Torge. Now we're also entering a time where I started making my own soundtracks.
Nimm nicht das Katzenfutter fressen! Ja, da wollen wir auch noch was von haben!
This is a platformer game with an infinite number of levels that I definitely made way more than 2 years ago, so I was first.
I have the receipts.
Pretty sure this was around the time when Plants vs. Zombies became popular. I've always been a big fan of nonsense. So in this game you control a little pink fishy that goes on a complete rampage. The era of widescreen games has begun. Pretty sure this was around the time Jetpack Joyride was popular. This is a game about melting your enemies, or should I say grinding for upgrades, or should I say me experimenting with gambling mechanics. A speedrun, top-down shooter, game thingy. This kinda looks like StarCraft to me. I'm not sure if I already played that back then.
It could be, I guess.
This is a tech demo with procedurally generated levels, intelligent enemies, and lighting.
Hey, look at that! I think that's the only intentionally scary game I've ever made in my life,
cause the other ones are not scary, or not intentional. My games kinda start looking better and better. Like, what is this? Is this progress everybody seems to be talking about? Like, even this year's firework simulator just looks way better than the previous one somehow. Just lacking sound effects. And my game ideas also started getting more and more unique and interesting. This is a puzzle game with procedurally generated puzzles, for example. This is a turn-based tower defense game with mining mechanics. Super weird concept, but that's why I love it. This is a really cool local multiplayer versus game where one player plays a strategy game and the other one plays a top-down shooter. It has upgrades, it has lots of different strategies. I love it. In this puzzle game, you can throw an object you can teleport to. You can also use it to press buttons and stuff, so it's a multi-purpose mechanic. Try to make a more realistic platforming gaming controller here.
This was the first and one of the only online multiplayer games I made.
And every time I see this game, I wanna play it so badly, but I can't because I don't know how to get this stupid IP stuff working.
It's a player versus player space battle game. You know, what better thing could there be?
This game's funny to me because it seems like a predecessor to the game I'm working on at the moment.
More on that later.
Colors. Pretty. Wow.
Oftentimes I took on these little programming challenges just for fun, like writing my own A-star pathfinding here.
Weird little synthesizer.
Stop moving, please. Can't you see the orange laser?
This is Mad Programmer, and I would consider this my first proper game release. I released it for free, but I just spent way more time on this than any other game before. The problem with it is that it has both super hard puzzles as well as super hard combat, which, just a little tip, is not a combination you should do in games. I was eager to get more stuff released, so I released my first mobile game called Rain of Death, where you have to dodge little raindrops. Unfortunately, you can't find this on the App Store anymore because it got deleted. You know, that's what happens when you don't update your game. Soon after, I teamed up with an artist for the very first time to create yet another mobile game that you can't get anymore. The cool thing about this game was that you could edit levels before playing them. So once again, it has puzzle components, it has action components. It works a little better in this game. We did try to sell the game, but also nobody bought it, so that is a thing that happened. At this point, I knew I wanted to get into game development full time, so I applied to a great game school in Berlin. And this is kind of a special game to me because this is the last game I made before I got accepted and started studying there. If you plot every game I've ever made on a graph with time on one axis and the quality of the games on the other, it would look something like this, with this being when I got accepted at game school. Like, this is the first game I made at university, in a team and with the help of professors, I have to add. It looks way different than everything I made before, let's just say that. Now, that didn't stop me from making my own garbage prototypes in my spare time. Of course I did that. Whenever I'm truly bored, I just make a little game or something. It's a little bit of a shame because oftentimes these have really interesting mechanics. Then others are just there to scratch my gambling itch. I joined a lot of game jams during my time in Berlin. I figured out that I really love collaborating with people. Here's a game jam game about shooting at each other with cows. Here's a game jam game where Santa has to turn a desert into a snowy landscape. Here's a game jam game about the game jam where we made the game jam game. If I remember correctly, this was the part I contributed. A little mini game where you have to find all of the bugs. Whereas I made most of my games with Game Maker before, I now really got the hang of using Unity. I learned more about shaders and particles and destructible terrain. A little player versus player game I made for an internship application. The assets were provided. Game school was nice, but the very best thing was actually the friends I made there. This is the first game Yen and me made in our spare time during game school. Complete nonsense game, which is exactly my thing. But instead of properly finishing that together, I made this crime of a mobile app. But no worries, I got to team up with Yen as well as two other very skilled students for the third semester project. This is Cake Shift, two grandpas beating each other up on a cake. It has terraforming, or should I say cake farming. It even has a separate upgrade picking phase before the match. Lots of strategy involved here, actually. I would love to play this way more often, but I can't because it's local multiplayer only. The good news is you can get it on itch for free if you want. I made even more friends at game school. I also met Paul and Friedman, with whom I made this little rhythm-based game here. And we also made a VR game together, which none of us can play anymore because nobody has a VR headset. It was actually a very cool sandbox game about animating little miniature scenes. But yeah, because we can't play it anymore, these videos are all that's left, the only historical evidence. This is a little short movie I made in the game.
I call it The Storm of Love.
You had a cute little camera you could move around, you had a cinema mode, and you had an export button. If you're having a bit of a deja vu, that's probably because I already made a video just like this one about 3 years ago. The reason I'm doing this again is because I found a bunch more old games and also made 3 years worth of new games. This is Ovis Nova, the first game I made after starting this YouTube channel. It's a very weird space strategy game where you have to sacrifice your own units to win. I unfortunately abandoned the project in favor of a different one though.
You play that snail here? Just supposed to be a little side project.
At this point I was still at game school, so for the sixth semester project I teamed up with Paul and Friedemann again. I joined their company, Grizzly Games, and I made my first commercial Steam release with them. Islanders. It's a minimalist city builder that almost plays a little bit like Tetris. For our standards, the game did pretty well. By the time you see this, it's already out on Switch, PlayStation, and Xbox. For the first time in my life, I felt like a real game developer. But even after that, nothing really changed. I just did what I always do, making more games. This is a game I literally made in 10 minutes for Brecky's 10-minute game dev challenge. There were a ton of small games I just made for this YouTube channel as well.
The infamous fun button game you all wanna play but will never get to.
Probably the hardest challenge I completed so far was making 50 games in one day. A record I intend to break very soon, so subscribe if you wanna see that. This is Overcharge, the best tower defense game I've made in my life so far, with fantastic sound design by Yen.
I also started hosting my own game jams. This is a game I made for my own jam, for example.
It feels very artsy-fartsy.
Ouroboros is a puzzle game about sacrificing your limbs. If we check out all of the games I made so far, then these are the ones I made in a team. And the great thing was, as my YouTube channel grew, so did my collaboration opportunities. I got to create Life is Snot with Noah from Blackthorn Prod, a game where aging changes your movement mechanics. I got to team up with old friends from game school to create Flubby Farmer,
a strategy game about farming flubbies.
I got to team up with strangers from the internet to create Spooked in Space. Collaborating with Noah from Blackthorn Prod was a lot of fun, so we did it again with Edgar's Blog. I made Pew Pew Crew with Yen, a space battle game where you use your crew members as ammunition. Then I teamed up with Noah and Yen to make where you play as a slightly overwhelmed kindergarten teacher. Recently we teamed up again, this time Liam from Blackthorn Prod joined in as well.
Jofish, behind you!
Please do yourself the favor and archive all of your work properly. Whatever your profession is, looking back at it 20 years from now is gonna be a lot of fun, I promise. Despite the fact that collaborations usually make for way better results, I actually made my latest game alone. My latest game is obviously also known as
The Little Side Project,
and I would love if you would consider wishlisting it on Steam to make sure that this game dev journey can continue, cause I wanna keep making cool stuff for you.
Hello, human. You are a snail, and I am a god, capable of predicting every move.